Welcome back. In the last two videos, we discussed the graphical analysis of an ODE. In this lecture, we will discuss the graphical method for a system of ODEs. This is a predator-prey model with two ODEs. We have two dependent variables, X and Y. X represents the number of prey in a forest and Y represents the number of predators. The predators eat the prey and their proliferation depends upon how much they eat. We want to know how X and Y change with time. We can create a three-dimensional plot with X, Y and T-axis and then visualize the time evolution of the system. However, it is difficult to draw and interpret a 3D plot. So we will draw a two-dimensional plot with X and Y axis. We will visualize the temporal change in X and Y on the plane, XY plane. For one-dimensional system, we used the direction field. We will take a similar approach, but now on the XY plane. Divide the area in an equally spaced grid. Take a grid point. Draw an arrow at that position. This arrow will represent the direction of change of X and Y from that position. The slope of this arrow is equal to dy dx. We can calculate dy dx from the system of ODEs. Dy dx is equal to dy dt into dt dx. Therefore, from our system of ODEs, we can write X into Y minus Y into 1 by X minus XY. Dy dx gives the slope of the arrow. But what would be the direction of the arrowhead? We can decide that by calculating dy dt and dx dt. If both the derivatives are positive, then with time, both x and y will increase. So the arrow at that position must point to the upper right corner. This way, we can decide the direction of arrow in all cases. Using this method, we can draw arrows at all the grid points. I have made the plot for the predator-prey model. This diagram is called a phase portrait or a phase plane plot. In fact, this is a vector field. The arrows or the vectors are representing the direction of motion of the system. Sometimes it helps to imagine the time evolution of our system as the flow of water. Using the phase portrait, we can visualize that flow. Each arrow represents the direction of the flow of water at that particular location. Our system of ODE is autonomous. So this flow pattern or the phase portrait does not change with time. Here is a question for you. We are drawing the phase portrait of a given system of ODEs. Find the slope and direction of the vector at x equal to 3 and y equal to 2. Hope you are done with the calculation. I have shown the phase plane plot for this system. Notice that the flow of the system is towards 0, 0, as if water from all over the place is moving towards the origin. In fact, x equal to 0, y equal to 0 is the steady state of this system. For a one-dimensional system, at the steady state, the dependent variable does not change with time. For a system of ODEs, all the dependent variables must stay constant at the steady state. That means derivatives of all the dependent variables must be zero at the steady state. So for the predator-prey model, at the steady state, both dy dt and dx dt must be zero. Setting both the derivatives 0, we get two equations, x minus xy equal to 0 and xy minus y equal to 0. Solving these two simultaneous equations, we get the steady states, x equal to 0, y equal to 0 and x equal to 1 and y equal to 1. There is also a graphical way to identify all possible steady states in a system. Draw the axis. Draw the x null line. X null line is a line on which the derivative of x is 0. Take the differential equation for x and set dx dt equal to 0. We get x minus xy equal to 0. Solving this equation, we get x equal to 0 or y equal to 1. So we have two null lines. One is x equal to 0 and the other one is y equal to 1. Draw the x null lines. Similarly, by setting dy dt equal to 0, we get the y null line. The y null lines are x equal to 1 and y equal to 0. The point of intersection between an x null line and a y null line is a steady state. In our predator-prey model, there are two steady states, 0,0 and 1,1. I have marked the steady states in the phase plane plot. Now we will check the behavior of the system around the steady state 1,1. Suppose initially the system was at x equal to 2 and y equal to 1. The vector at this position indicates that with time the system will move in this direction. So x will decrease and y will increase. Then it will follow the vector at the new position. Starting with that initial position, the system will revolve around the steady state and come back to its original position. So we will get a closed trajectory around the steady state. A closed trajectory on the phase plane means both x and y have oscillation. Initially, the number of preys was high. As the predators eat those, the prey population drops. But the number of predators increases as they reproduce more. After some time, there will be almost no prey to feed. So the predator population will drop and the prey population would come back. Here I have given the JSIM code for the predator-prey model. Try to simulate the behavior with different initial conditions. So here are the key points of this lecture. For a system of ODEs, the dynamics of the system can be visualized on the phase portrait or the phase plane plot. Remember, the axis of the phase plane plot are two dependent variables. The slope of each arrow or vector in the phase portrait is equal to the derivative of one dependent variable with respect to the other. A null line is a line on the phase plane that the corresponding dependent variable does not change along that line. For example, on x null line, dx dt will be 0. Similarly, on the y null lines, dy dt will be 0. At a steady state, all the dependent variables remain constant and their derivatives are equal to 0. The intersection of null lines are the steady states.